In this video in our series about developing a personal practice, I'm going to introduce you to someone who's had her own practice for over 30 years. We're going to offer you some tips about getting your practice started or strengthening your practice if you've already got one going. We are going to be allies to your commitment in practicing so you can develop and get better at what you like to do. So here we go. Let's pour a cup of tea and we'll get started. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, Marie.
You're welcome.
I want to introduce you to Marie Favorito. She is the director of the Boston Healing Tao School for Taoist Practices. She's teaching Tai Chi, meditation, and Qigong for a long, long, long time. And she's got some great things to share with you about practicing. You've been developing a personal practice and actively enjoying a personal practice for 30 years now. Yes. And a long time that I've known you. It's been very inspiring. So what kind of tips can you give to someone who's just beginning a personal practice?
Well, it starts with a thought and an inspiration, an idea, whatever it is. I do Qigong, Tai Chi, meditation. And I do that on a daily basis to feel good. So you get started and you take it one day at a time. And what happens is you get it, you anchor it. You anchor a good feeling in your body and it inspires you to want to do it again. So it's getting to the point of just getting started. Not worrying about perfection. You know, just producing enough time, maybe 15 minutes, 10, 15 minutes, but something that you can really do. And promise yourself that you can do it. And then be persistent. Every day, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, get started and anchor that good feeling you get from accomplishing your goal, accomplishing the feeling from doing Qigong or Tai Chi. Inspiration.
Okay, so that can certainly help you get started, and the continuation of your practice can build on the previous day's good feeling. So how do you maintain your practice and keep going on those days where you don't feel like you're getting anywhere, or you really don't feel like you're developing, but you did sit and you did your meditation or you did your practice of whatever kind it is? How do you keep going when it feels like you're hitting a wall or can be frustrating too?
You gotta have some support. You have to have something set up, whether it's a community of people of like-mindedness, a community of people who are trying to accomplish the same goals, a community of people who are going to support you and have fun, you know, not worry about perfection. It's about doing it, and every day you get better at it, you feel more, you anchor that feeling, and you're going to want to practice every day. I've been practicing this work, this Qigong, for 30 years because it feeds me. It makes me feel good. And I love sharing it with people. I truly do. And then it's about frequency and vibration. It helps you center your body. It helps you raise your vibration, having a practice of some sort. It helps you be clear. It helps you accomplish your tasks in the day more efficiently.
Because you've practiced. And your practice is energy cultivation, so you're clearing your energy every time you practice. Very nice.
And everybody wants more energy.
Right? Yeah, I would say so. Yeah, there's no shortage of that.
Yeah.
So let's say there's someone who comes to you and they have a very strong practice. They're really committed. It's making a difference in their life, but they'd like to up their game a little bit. You know, they'd like to maybe take it to the next level, whatever that is. But how can you help someone who's already practicing strengthen their practice?
You have to know where your students are at. Where they want to go. You have to know what they've accomplished and where they want to go, what their goals are. So then you can say, well, you can do this practice or that practice and, you know, practice more time with this level or that level, a deeper stance or the higher level meditation or a more complicated Qigong movement or going from a short form to a long form or maybe adding sword form. So you have to know your students and take it from there.
One of the things that Marie and I have been talking about for quite some time now is a way to help people to stay with their practice. We get them started, they're doing great on their own, and then we hear from them or something crashes and burns, or maybe they're taking care of other people and they're having a hard time devoting some time to themselves. Mm-hmm. So Marie and I are working towards putting together a group where we can connect online, because obviously not everybody lives near we are, or they can come to our classes and benefit from that live interaction. But some of you have a practice or would like to find a way to develop a practice of your own, and so we're going to connect with you online.
Having a group online to help us be accountable, to help you be accountable to your practice, is fantastic. You know, this technology allows us to help people everywhere.
We're going to be putting together a Facebook group where we can all meet and help you through your commitment to practice. And everybody in the group is also going to be an ally to your commitment, whatever it is that you're choosing to practice. In the next video, we're going to continue with a little more detail about that, and we're going to help you understand the purpose that can be behind your practice. How does that sound?
It sounds fantastic, and you are invited.
You're invited. It's time for more tea?
More tea.
Uh-oh. We'll see you in the next video.